Back to It's Better with Ryan. My name is Brian Nevisman, and I'm here today with Project Runway designer Mah-Jing Wong.
Hello,
Mah-Jing, what's up?
What's up,
Mah-Jing in the house? All right, so Mah-Jing, let's talk Project Runway. So when and how did you decide to go on the show?
Okay, well, about 4 years ago, I tried out initially. They asked me to come to New York. I couldn't come. So then each year, they would email me asking to try out. And I went further and further, even as far as filling out paperwork. And then last year, when I was getting ready to audition, they emailed me and told me to try out. When I sent my patient through, they called me, and it kind of just happened.
So you mentioned it was your fourth time. Is there a lot of stuff behind the scenes?
Well, I don't know. In terms of trying out for the show, it's very simple. It's either you just try out for the occasion that they call you, you come to New York, you do three judges, some of them open this. When I went, it was Mondo, Sean Kelly, there was a young lady from Marie Claire, she also was a swimwear designer.
Cool.
She was there. And then it seems as if like they really know and I got made when I went in. They had called me to come in. But as soon as I walked out, they found me and asked me to come in the next day. Or you gave me money, I want to come back to do another interview. So it was kind of weird. It seemed like it was like an answer that certain things are done for the TV to get the, they don't want you to know what's going to happen. So they have to switch things up. Somebody like me who's on the show don't even know.
Yeah.
And I've been like, is this like going to happen right now?
Can you just tell me,
am I going to get an opinion? It just happened. They called me. No. I know. This is long, y'all. Okay, this is even juicier.
Oh, God, we love the juice.
When they told me I got it, I did everything they asked me to do. And then I got an email inside again. They said, wasn't the right fit this year, trying out next year. I emailed them back and said, oh, my God, I spent my last allowance coming to New York to try out for the show. They said, we know you, my dude. Let's try it again. And then I got a phone call a week later. I'm like, oh, did you do your better performance? And I said, better performance than what? Y'all showed me I didn't get it. And then I got it. They waited until I got Skype. I guess they wanted me to have that surprise element. So I should have known up front they were going to hit me with a dance.
Yeah. Well, you made it. That's awesome.
Yeah, that was good.
So let's talk about the show, too. So what was the greatest challenge that you faced on the show? So I know they have you going through a bunch of different competitions and high energy stuff, and you have an hour or something to do an activity.
Well, you know what? That's another thing that the world is going to get is that we do get the amount of time they say we get 10 or 12 hours. We actually do get 10 or 12 hours. We get a mandatory 20-minute lunch break is mandatory. That's lunch. Now, dinner is optional, up to you if you want to eat. But lunch, you have to stop because something just passed out from you working the whole straight time.
Did a lot of people take the dinner break?
Yeah, we had to go. It's pretty intense. I didn't always eat every single time, but when I was stressed, I ate 15 pounds of the show. But, it's pretty intense. The hardest part, back to your question, the hardest part about the show was moving away from my family, but also too, because I wanted it so bad, and I wanted to see so bad that I was second guessing myself. And it was I didn't like that about myself. I almost felt like I was bouncy in the bed when it came to my talent.
Did they control you on the show and tell you what to do? Or
no.
Did you have complete freedom over it?
Me first, they didn't do it.
Okay.
I was nice. I had the scenes over the weekend, and I was really on my production. They were really, really nice to me. They didn't force me to do anything that was outside my character. The only thing I didn't like was to work mic'd all the time. You offer for each bar mic'd and I don't get a second call. I just sit there and then tell them, I say, oh my God, I don't want this to look costume. And then tell them, say, well, it kind of looks costume-y. And then to make me laugh. And I go, how did you do it? I'm like, mic.
Yeah, so that's interesting. So that you sign off for everything that they can use, any footage of you, I guess.
Yeah. You give up a lot.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Your likeness, your character for the show, you do give up. And it's up to them to decide how they want to portray you. The only thing you can do when you go on reality TV is be yourself. They can't make that up.
Yeah, that's so true. That's great advice. All right, well then, how has Project Runway impacted your career, and especially with your family, too? Can you talk a little bit about that?
Yeah, it changed a lot. For one, before we were on the show, I was worried about my career. When when I was on the show in this category. And what happened was I get recognized all of the time. It just happened when I was driving my car. Oh my God, you're from Project Runway. Love you. I hear people scream out the cars. The whole station park is really, it's weird, but it's all at the top of my mind to the drip. Okay? When I get done, it gives me extra. It's like, you know what, this is why I do what I do.
Yeah.
People say the love and the appreciation to the art, you know?
Was it weird at first getting that attention from all these strangers?
I mean, you know, every now and again, depending upon what demographic I'm in, people may say, oh, you're the guy who did the dress for so-and-so. But now, like, I'm from Mah-Jing Wong, no, you're Mah-Jing. Sometimes they don't even take projects over, they just say, yes, Mah-Jing. I'm myself. But, like, it did get weird too, like, crying sometimes. And I, not to say there was something, but I guess when I went home, the speech I gave, seeing touched on the line, I was just searching myself that day. I guess I'm like, wait a minute.
Yeah, very cool. Awesome. All right, well, and then let's talk your career. So let's step aside from Project Runway.
Yes.
Can you tell me about where you've been since Project Runway?
Okay.
I mean, fashion shows.
Philly Fashion Week show, so I did two shows in Philly Fashion Week. I have another show coming in Boston. I have another show coming in
Oklahoma.
I've just been getting offers to do different shows. One, like in New Jersey. Just different things I've been acting to, and I'm going to choose the best things that come inside who I am as an individual.
Yeah.
You can't jeopardize your soul who you are. And my career, it helped me a lot. Like, I have to see the pain sometimes, but for most part, people are offering to shoot the stuff that work with me, and I don't have to go through it anymore. Because I guess my, like, the show, it's put online.
Yeah, that's
awesome.
Thanks,
show.
Thanks, Project Runway.
Yeah, every time I see the magazine cover, which I've got some physical magazine. I have another show out in New York, it's a big styling company. I have a new agency in LA that I'm going to be signing.
Wow, congratulations. That's awesome.
So it's a lot of stuff. I feel puzzled because there's so much in my brain. Oh my God.
How do you handle it all?
I don't even.
Going from Fashion Week to a magazine cover to LA, like, crazy.
It's a lot of fun. It's a blessing. I asked for it and it started to happen. I've got a long way to go in my career, but a lot of different doors that I want to open up.
Okay.
I just did a fashion film. Just so we do, we're editing it.
Very cool. Well, how will viewers be able to watch that?
Okay, well, that's going to be coming out in another week. And I'm going to post on social media. And I'll put it on YouTube and maybe my website.
Cool.
You know.
I'll have to look out for it. Awesome.
Yes.
So, let's talk your clients. So, can you tell us a little bit about your clients? Like, what draws people to your brand, I guess?
Oh, you know what? In the beginning of my career, I love to use color and body colors,
nice.
And they kind of correlate to denim. My love for denim, and I blend the two together. I do it with knit, solid, whatever. But right now, I'm just doing flat out denim in a like that. I mean, denim is a classic textile, not never going anywhere. I just made a dress to work for Ivy. She showed me around some daughter, which related from Bodie's mother.
Yeah.
Well, yeah. So,
no way.
I just did her blog site, and that's super cool.
Such a small world. Yeah. Have you worked with any celebrities too?
Oh, yeah. Tons of celebrities. Prior to the show, I think Shine did really good.
Wow.
Even myself, that's my model. I've done so many. Okay. A lot of reality shows.
Well, do you have like a dream client then? You should, and she's coming for the picnic, the Roots picnic, June 3rd.
Yes.
So you might as well hit her up.
I can finesse that. I'm gonna hit up some people and say, trust you.
She's awesome.
She is super dope. I think her style is so unique and so her. And it's so edgy, but yet it's refreshing, you know? And I'm also the best of the biggest things. I'm really excited about that. And,
cool. Well, do you have any advice for emerging artists or people who want to go through the whole fashion industry?
I would say be limitless and be diligent. Be yourself. Don't hold back. Don't overthink nothing. Be yourself. And you can never go wrong with it. Because you only can be yourself and you can edit it along the way. You know, sometimes we'll overdo it and look back and say, let's go back a little bit. Find it. You'll never block yourself.
Yeah. That's great advice. Yeah. All right, so what's next for you and your career? Where do you want to end up in the next, like, 5 years?
Okay. In 5 years, I'm going to be back on TV. Call me for All Stars because I want to do the show. I want to do All Stars. I think that's amazing. More TV, more hosting gigs. I want to see my stuff in movies, next, more red carpet, more celebrities, more magazine covers.
Wow.
I really want to skies look good. I want to really take, especially after my career looks to be a lot. And now the world,
Girl can strut. So, alright, well, that's it. Thanks for watching. It's Better with Brian. I'll see you next time.